This is what it's all about right here. I don't know if you could, this was a good idea up here on this little seal. When I could see it on my computer just fine, but can you see what it says in the middle of that? It's in red and it doesn't show up, but it says paid. So that's like a paid stamp when somebody stamps your receipt. And you probably can see what it says around the other part. It says amount received in full, approved and delivered. And there's the deliverer over on the other side. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face. And those things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. In the light of his glory and grace. What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap? He's sleepy. Do angels greet with songs so sweet while shepherds there watch? This is Christ, a king who shepherds God and angels sing. Haste to break and parade this babe, the son of Mary. Now lazy in that stable bed where ox and lamb feed. Christians fear for sinners here. The silent word is pleading. This is Christ, the King, the shepherd's God, and angels sing. Haste to bring and parade this babe, the son of Mary. So bring him incense, gold, and myrrh. Come, peasant king, to own him, the King of Kings, salvation brings with loving hearts enthroned him. Now this is Christ, our King, who shepherds God and angels sing. bring him praise. This babe, the son of Mary. Tears are falling, hearts are breaking. How we need to hear from God. You have been promised, and we've been waiting. Welcome, Holy Child. Welcome, Holy Child. Hope that you don't mind our manger. How I wish we would have known. But long awaited, holy stranger, make yourself at home. Please make yourself at home. Bring your peace in to our violence. Bid our hungry souls be filled. Word now breaking, heaven's silence. Welcome to our world. Welcome to our world. Fragile finger sent to heal us. Tender brow prepared for thorn. Tiny heart whose blood will save us. Unto us is born. Unto us is born. So wrap our injured flesh around you. Breathe our air and walk our side. Rob our sin and make us holy. Perfect Son of God. Perfect Son of God. Welcome to our world.
There's one line in that song that really jumps out to me. It's this line that says, tiny heart whose blood will save us. Amazing. Mary gets a lot of cred this time of year, but sometimes Joseph is in the background. Actually, Mary and Joseph can both be in the background because we know who we're really singing about, but they played a big part in this. And, Joseph could have chosen a different path, but he decided to hang around and help raise his stepson. So this is called It Wasn't His Child. He was her man, she was his wife. Late one winter's night, he knelt by her as she gave birth. But it wasn't his child, wasn't his child. Yet still he took him as his own. And as he watched him grow,
He brought him joy. He loved that boy, but it wasn't his child. It wasn't his child. And like a father, he was strong and kind and good. And I believe he did his best. It wasn't easy for him, but he did all he could. His son was different from the rest. It wasn't his child. It wasn't his child. And soon the boy became a man and took his father's hand. And soon the world would all know why, that it wasn't his child. It wasn't his child. And like a father, he was strong and kind and good. And I believe he did his best. It wasn't easy for him, but he did all he could. He grew up with his hands in wood, and he died with his hands in wood. He was her man, she was his wife. And late one winter night, he knelt by her, 'cause she gave birth. But it wasn't his child. He was God's child.
Alrighty, well, you guys can help me out in these next few. You know, we always typically here we have a lady song, we have a men's song, and then we have, I call it an all skate. If you remember back going, those of you who went to Academy, what was it, Midway we used to go to, and the all skate probably means something to you. But this will be the lady song, and if the men want to sing falsetto and sing along, I'll never tell. But let's sing together. The words will be right up there on the screen, so ladies can sing along with me.
Oh, come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye, oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of England. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Sing choirs of angels, sing in exaltation. Oh, sing all ye citizens of heaven above. Glory to God. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Yea, Lord, we greet thee on this happy morning. Oh, Jesus, to thee be all glory given. Word of the Father, now impress your hearing. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ.
We don't want to leave the men out, so or the gentlemen, I should say. We don't want to leave them out. So if you qualify as a gentleman, sing along with us on this song. And if the ladies want to drop down to their lower register, they can sing along with us too.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. God our Heavenly Father, a blessed angel came, and unto certain shepherds brought tidings of the same. Now that in Bethlehem was born the Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Now to the Lord sing praises, all you within this place, and with true love and brotherhood each other now embrace. This holy tide of Christmas all others earth and face. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
All right, well, you saw the title of our program today was, well, maybe, does anybody remember what the first slide said? Other than the paid in full stamp on the side we talked about. At the top, it was, as titled, it was Special Delivery. It was a celebration of God's indescribable gift. And the story that I'm going to bring to you right after this song is called Delayed Delivery. And this song was a song I wrote. I probably sang it for you before, but it was it's called December Right on Time. So actually, you know, even though sometimes, you know, nowadays we check tracking numbers for everything, right? We ordered it, we're wondering where it is, how come it's not here today, and we look at the tracking number and, oh man, it's stuck in Cincinnati or who knows. I mean, but you know, God came at just the right time. Some, I'm sure, were thinking this was, it had been way too long. They were waiting way too long. And I know that a lot of us are feeling, waiting for a second coming, that we're waiting way too long. How many people before us have passed on and we're still waiting? That's a delayed delivery that's coming. Delayed in our minds, but just on time in His. So this is December, right on time. The north wind is a-blowing, and the Christmas lights a-glowing, in the parking lot, they're selling spruce and pine. The streets, they are a-bustling, and the shoppers are a-hustling. Never seen a longer checkout line. I hear them bells ringing, and the coins they started jingling, part with some quarters as I hurry by. Walk on and I'm thinking, just who will those coins be helping as the snowflakes gently flutter from the sky? Oh, December, glad you showed up right on time. Been waiting for you just about a year, and longing for some hefty dose of cheer.
favorite time of year. This is mine. Oh, December, glad you showed up right on time. That snow, it's barely sticking. Some are melting, some are freezing. Flakes of every size and shape and every kind. Got just that kind of inkling. Those are steeple bells clanging. That sound I hear, it's not just in my mind. See the candles in the window of the church down in the hollow, the place where those who seek him surely find. There are shepherds, there are wise men, once strangers, now they're good friends, standing side by side to honor the Christ child. Oh, December, I'm glad you showed up right on time. I've been waiting for you just about a year, and longing for your hefty dose of cheer. Favorite time of year, this is mine. Oh, December, glad you showed up right on time. Yes, December, I'm glad you're right on time.
We're looking at the clock. I should skip this story, but this story is too good, and I'm not going to skip it. So what I'm going to share with you is a story written by Kathy Miller in a book that's not in print anymore called A Family Christmas. And her story is titled Delayed Delivery, as we talked about the tracking number. And I was singing the last, as I was singing my, the last song I just sang, it reminded me of yesterday. I had to run some errands, and I came out of the store. There was a guy with a Salvation Army bucket ringing his bell, and in this song it talks about, I hear the bells are ringing and the coins, they started jingling, part with some quarters as I hurry by. And I threw some quarters in his bucket for him because I thought of that. And then the other one is that never seen a longer checkout line. Could not believe it. There are people just getting groceries. I mean, it wasn't like they were out Christmas shopping, but, you know, like, you see the self-checkout lines, and those are like halfway down the, you know, down another aisle in the store. I'm like, I'm not going to go through there. There's this one checkout line that looked a little shorter, and the people in the checkout line didn't have very much in their cart, right? I thought. So I got in that line, and the lady that was at the checkout counter right there at that, the first one in line there, didn't have very much in her cart, but I guess she must have been buying gift cards for everybody at, or that she knew. And they have to activate every single one of those. So we sat there. The guy behind me, we just started talking and laughing. And what are you going to do? I said, there's nothing you can do. And just waited. I said, if you're in a hurry, don't come here. And then the lady before me gets her groceries on the conveyor belt. And they come up to the thing. And all of a sudden the lady goes, oh. My cash register's froze up because have to have a cash pickup. I guess she had too much money in her drawer, so she has to call the manager, you know, and 5 minutes later he comes out of somewhere and takes some money out of her drawer, and off we go. And finally we got there, and when I finally got into the car, I texted my wife. I said, finally. But there's a lot of truth in that, those words we just sang. Anyway, delayed delivery. There had never been a winter like this. Stella watched from the haven of her armchair as gusts of snow whipped themselves into a frenzy. She feared to stand close to the window, unseasonably afraid that somehow the blizzard might be able to reach her there, sucking her breathless out into the chaos. The houses across the street were all but obliterated by the fury of wind-borne flakes
Absently, the elderly woman straightened the slipcovers on the armchairs, her eyes glued to the spectacle beyond the glass. Dragging her gaze away from the window, she forced herself up out of her chair and waited a moment for balance to reassert itself. Straightening her back against the pain that threatened to keep her stooped, she set out determinedly for the kitchen. In the doorway to the next room, she paused, her mind blank, wondering what purpose had propelled her there. From the vent above the stove, the scream of the wind threatened to funnel the afternoon storm directly down into the tiny house. Stella focused brown eyes on the stovetop clock. The 3:15 time reminded her that she had headed in there to take something out of the freezer for her supper. Another lonely meal that she didn't feel like preparing, much less eating. Suddenly, she grabbed the cool, white surface of the door as a wave of self-pity threatened to drown her. It was too much to bear. Losing her beloved Dave this summer, how was she to endure the pain, the daily nothingness? She felt the familiar ache in her throat and squeezed her eyes tightly shut to hold the tears at bay. Stella drew herself upright and shook her head in silent chastisement. She reiterated her litany of thanks. She had her health. She had her tiny home, an income that should suffice for the remainder of her days. She had her books, her television programs, her needlework. Well, there were the pleasures of her gardening in the spring and summer, walk through the wilderness park at the end of her street, and the winter birds that brightened the feeder outside her kitchen window. Not today, though, she thought ruefully, as the blizzard hurled itself against the eastern wall of her kitchen. Ah, Dave, I miss you so. I never minded storms when you were here. The sound of her own voice echoed hollowly in the room. She turned on the radio that stood on the counter next to a neatly descending row of wooden canisters. A sudden joyful chorus of Christmas music filled the room, but it only served to deepen her loneliness. She'd been prepared for her husband's death. Since the doctor's pronouncements of terminal lung cancer, they had both faced the inevitable, striving to make the most of their remaining time together. Dave's financial affairs had always been put in order. There were no new burdens in her widowed state. It was just the awful loneliness, the lack of purpose to her days. They had been a childless couple. It had been their choice. Their lives had been full of rich things. They had been content with busy careers and with each other. They had many friends. Had. That was the operative word these days. It was bad enough losing the one person you loved with all your heart. But over the past few years, she and Dave repeatedly had to cope with the deaths of their friends and relations. They were all of an age, the age when human bodies begin giving up, dying. Face it, they were old. And now, on this first Christmas without Dave, Stella would be on her own. Mabel and Jim had invited her to spend the holiday with them in Florida, but somehow that had seemed worse than staying at home alone. Not only would she miss her husband, but she would miss the snow in the winter and the familiarity of home. With shaky fingers, she lowered the volume on the radio so that the music became a muted background. She glanced through the fridge briefly, then decided that a hot bowl of soup would be more comforting fare this evening. To her surprise, she saw that the mail had come. She hadn't even heard the creak of the levered mail slot in the front door. Poor mailman out in this weather, she thought. Neither hail nor sleet. With the inevitable wince of pain, she bent to retrieve the damp white envelopes from the door. Moving it to the living room, she sat on the piano bench to open them. They were mostly Christmas cards, and her sad eyes smiled at the familiarity of the traditional scenes and the loving messages inside. Carefully, her arthritic fingers arranged them along the other clustered on top of the piano. In her entire house, they were the only seasonal decoration. The holiday was less than a week away, but yet, she did not have the heart
to put up a silly tree or even set up the stable that Dave had built with his own hands. Suddenly engulfed by the loneliness of it all, Stella buried her lined face in her hands, lowered her elbows to the piano keys in a harsh, abrasive discord, and let the tears come. How would she possibly get through Christmas and the winter beyond it? She longed to climb into bed and bury herself in a cocoon of blankets, not emerging until her friends in spring returned. But then, the ring of the doorbell echoed the high-pitched, discordant piano notes and were so unexpected that Stella had to stifle a small scream of surprise. Now, who could possibly be calling on her on a day like today? Wiping her eyes, she noticed for the first time how dark the room had become. The doorbell sounded a second time. Using the piano for leverage, she raised herself upright and headed for the front hall, switching on the living room light as she passed. She opened the wooden door and stared through the screen window of the storm door in consternation. On her front porch, buffeted by waves of wind and snow, stood a strange young man whose hatless head was barely visible above the large carton in his arms. She peered beyond him in the driveway, but there was nothing but a small car to give a clue to his identity. Returning her gaze to him, she saw that his hands were bare and his eyebrows had lifted in an expression of hopeful appeal that was fast disappearing behind the frost forming on the glass. Summoning courage, the elderly woman opened the door slightly and stepped sideways to speak into the space. "Mrs. Thornhope?" She nodded in affirmation, her extended arm beginning to tremble with cold and the strain of holding the door against the wind. He spoke again. "I have a package for you." Curiosity drove warning thoughts from her mind. She pushed the door far enough to enable the stranger to shoulder it and step back into the foyer to make room for him. He entered, bringing with him the frozen breath of the storm. Smiling, he placed the burden carefully on the floor and stood to retrieve the envelope that protruded from his pocket. As he handed it to her, a sound came from the box. Stella actually jumped. The man laughed an apology and bent to straighten up the cardboard flaps, holding them open for her to peek inside. She advanced cautiously and then turned her gaze downward. It was a dog. To be more exact, it was a golden retriever, a Labrador retriever puppy. As the gentleman lifted its squirming body up into his arms, he explained, "This is for you, ma'am. He's 6 weeks old, but he's completely housebroken." The young pup wiggled in happiness as he was being released from captivity and thrust his ecstatic wet kisses in the direction of his benefactor's chin. "We were supposed to deliver him on Christmas Eve," he continued with some difficulty as he strove to rescue his chin from the wet little tongue. "But the staff at the kennel start their holidays tomorrow. Hope you don't mind an early present." Shock had stolen her ability to think clearly. Unable to form coherent sentences, she stammered. "But who?" The young fellow set the animal down on the doormat between them and then reached out a finger to tap the envelope that she was still holding. "There's a letter in there that explains everything pretty much. The dog was bought last July while her mother was still pregnant. It was meant to be a Christmas gift. If you'll just wait a minute, there are some things in the car I'll get for you." Before she could protest, he was gone, returning a moment later with a huge box of dog food, a leash, and a book called Caring for Your Labrador Retriever. All this time, the puppy had sat quietly at her feet, panting happily as his brown eyes watched her. Unbelievably, the stranger was turning to go. Desperation forced her words from her lips. "But who? Who brought it?" Pausing in the open doorway, his words almost snatched away by the wind that tousled the air, he replied, "Your husband, ma'am." And then he was gone. It was all in the letter. Forgetting the puppy entirely at this sight of the familiar handwriting, Stella had walked like a somnambulist to her chair by the window, unaware that the little dog had followed her. She forced tear-filled eyes to read her husband's words. He had written it 3 weeks before his death and had left it with the kennel owners to be delivered along with the puppy as his last Christmas gift to her. It was full of love and encouragement and admonishments to be strong.
He vowed that he was waiting for a day when she would join him, and he had sent her this young animal to keep her company until then. Remembering the little creature for the first time, she was surprised to find him quietly looking up at her. His small panting mouth resembled a comic smile. Stella put the pages aside and reached down for the bundle of golden fur. She thought that he would be heavier, but he was only the size and weight of a small pillow, so soft and warm. She cradled him in her arms. He licked her jawbone, then cuddled up into the hollow of her neck. The tears began anew at this exchange of affection, and the dog endured her crying without moving. Finally, Stella lowered him to her lap, where he regarded her solemnly. She wiped vaguely at her wet cheeks, then somehow mustered a smile. "Well, little guy, I guess it's up to you and me." His pink tongue panted in agreement. Stella's smile strengthened, and her gaze shifted sideways to the window. Dusk had fallen, and the storm seemed to have spent the worst of its fury. Through fluffy flakes that were now drifting down at a gentler pace, she saw the cheery Christmas lights that edged the roof lines of her neighbors' homes. The strains of joy to the world wafted in from the kitchen. Suddenly, Stella felt the most amazing sensation of peace and benediction washing over her. It was like being enfolded in a loving embrace. Her heart beat painfully, but it was with joy and wonder, not grief or loneliness. She need never feel lonely again. Returning her attention to the dog, she spoke to him. "You know, fella, I've got a box in the basement. I think you'd like it. There's a tree in it and some decorations and lights that will impress you like crazy. And I think I can find that old stable down there, too. What do you say we go hunt it up?" Well, the puppy barked happily in agreement, as if he understood every word. Well, that's where this story ends. But it reminds us that love is stronger than death and reaches into eternity. Love gives gifts of kindness coming from loving hearts that can warm the coldest winter and bring light into darkness and lonely places. And once upon a dark night, in a little village called Bethlehem, every one of us received a gift like no other. It was a gift of surprising kindness, a gift of enduring love, a gift to this day warms hearts, releases captives, pushes back the shadows, delivers hope and joy to transform desolate seasons of our lives. Some may say that Stella's gift from her husband of renewed life in the form of a cuddly puppy was delayed, but he knew when she would need it the most and planned accordingly. God's great gift delivered just when we needed it the most will walk us through every trial, every hardship, every lonely day, and every starless night. And one day we'll all be together in the presence of the gift where loneliness and death and separation and tears will fade like a distant dream. The gift is ours right now, and his name is Jesus. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. That's why I couldn't skip it. Well, there's delayed deliveries and then there's special deliveries. Never was anyone like him. Never will one be the same. Tiny babe and infant king, Savior, we worship and honor the power of his name. Oh, he came special delivery, wrapped up in love, bound by a promise, sealed by a dove, and filled with the Spirit, carried by grace. You know where he was going by the look on his face. Where he went,
Love was there also. Where he was, love showed the way. Those who saw knew he was holy. And I see what they saw to this very day. Oh, he came special delivery, wrapped up in love, bound by a promise, sealed by a dove, filled with the Spirit, carried by grace. And you knew where he was going by the look on his face. When I'm called, I will go gladly. I will not grieve for the past, for I know where I'll be going. And I will be going to see him at last. I'm going special delivery, wrapped up in love, bound by a promise, sealed by a dove, filled with the Spirit, carried by grace. You'll know where I'm going by the look on my face. Going special delivery, wrapped up in love, bound by a promise, sealed by a dove, filled with the Spirit, carried by grace. And you'll know where I am going by the look on my face.
All righty, this is the Allskate, guys. The first Noel, let's all sing together. Give me a little bit of time to get myself put back together after that tearjerker story. The first Noel, the angel did say, was to certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay in fields where they lay keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so deep. Noel, 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 born is the King of Israel. They looked up and saw a star shining in a east beyond them far. And to the earth it gave great light, and so it continued both day and night. Noel, 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 born is the King of Israel. And by the light of that same star, three wise men came from country far to see, for a king was their intent, and to follow that star wherever it went. Noel, 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 born is the King of Israel. This star drew nigh to the northwest, or Bethlehem
It took its rest and left. It did both stop and stay right over the place where Jesus lay. Nowhere. Born is the King of Israel. Then entered in those wise men three, full reverently upon the knee, and offered there in his presence their gold and myrrh and frankincense. Noel. Born is the King of Israel.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder grace, a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices, oh, night divine. Oh, night when Christ was born. Oh, night divine. Oh, night divine. Led by the light of a face serenely beaming, with glowing hearts by his cradle we stand. So led by light of a star sweetly gleaming, he came the wise man from Orient land. The King of Kings lay thus in lowly manger. In all our trials, born to be our friend, he knows our need. To our weakness, he's no stranger. Behold your King before the lonely bed. Behold your King before him bent. Now truly he taught us to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord, and ever praise be his name.
evermore proclaim His power and glory evermore
Again, another song that I wrote, but the idea wasn't original. It was a sermon title to a sermon that the preacher was preaching one Christmas season when we were visiting Ruth's folks in Pennsylvania. So I asked him if I could borrow the idea and turn it into a song. And the next year, I brought him the recorded version. So this wraps up the Christmas story, as we've talked about before. It didn't just stop at the cradle. If it did, it wouldn't have been finished. Obviously, the story continues on to the cross so that we each can be promised a crown in heaven. Not wrapped in paper with ribbons and bows, placed under the tree so no one would know what might be inside or for whom it may be. His gift was for all men to see. A cradle, a cross, and a crown. From heaven above He came down. He placed His gift up on that tree for all of His children for eternity. A cradle, a cross, and a crown. No greater love could be found. Laid in a cradle and hung on a cross to give us the gift of a crown. Well, He left His home and made our home His. Lived among men, showed us just how to live. Took on the blame for what we had done to offer these gifts to everyone. A cradle, a cross, and a crown. From heaven above He came down. He placed His gift up on a tree for all of His children for eternity. A cradle, a cross, and a crown. No greater love could be found. Laid in a cradle and hung on a cross to give us the gift of a crown. Cradle, a cross, and a crown. From heaven above He came down. He placed His gift up on that tree for all of His children for eternity. A cradle, a cross, and a crown. There was no greater love to be found. Laid in a cradle and hung on a cross to give us the gift of a crown. Laid in a cradle and hung on a cross just to give us the gift of a crown.
This next song was actually the first song that I'll claim to have written. We were living in Urbandale, and we had received a Christmas card from John and Linda Sears. Many of you, I'm sure, may have received Christmas cards from them over the years. And on the back of the card was empty. Nothing was on it except, you know, the little copyright on the bottom or whatever.
And I was we had a wood stove in our living room, and I was remember laying there in a warm wood stove, these thoughts came to mind, and so this was the song that came out of that was written on the back of the Christmas card that John and Linda. I actually saved that card, still have it, and have the original words on the back of it. So,
hear the bells on Christmas Day, the old familiar carols play. Jesus Christ was born a king. He was born, so let us sing. The babe in swaddling clothes he came, not with fortune nor with fame. As we live, he do the same. But for our sins, he take the blame. Hallelujah to his name. We shall never be the same. By his word we shall be led, by every word that he has said. Surely he is coming soon, for each and every one of you. He will take us to his home, this land no more will have to roam. Oh, hear the bells on Christmas Day, heed the words they have to say. Let this baby be your king, your heart, your soul, your everything. Oh, hallelujah to his name. We shall never be the same. By his word we shall be led, by every word that he has said. Oh, let this baby be your king, your heart, your soul, your everything. And let his love make you sing.
And what do we sing?
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature see, and heaven and nature see, and heaven and heaven and nature see.
The song we're going to close with today is a song by Rich Mullins called My Deliverer. And those folks waited for their king, their deliverer, to come years ago. And we're doing the same thing at this time, not expecting him to come as a baby in a manger, but in the clouds in heaven on that white horse to take us all back home with him.
Joseph took his wife and her child, and they went to Africa to escape the rage of a deadly king. There along the banks of the Nile, Jesus listened to the song that the captive children used to sing. They were singing, my deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. Through a day of thirsty land, water from the canyon high pours itself out of Lake Sangre's broken heart. There in the Sahara wind, Jesus heard the whole world cry for the healing that would flow from his own scars. And the world was singing, my deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. Well, he will never break his promise, he has written it upon the sky. My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. I will never doubt his promise, though I doubt my heart, I doubt my eyes. My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. My deliverer, he's coming, my deliverer is standing by. My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. Well, I will never doubt his promise, though I doubt my heart, I doubt my eyes. My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by.
Let's bow our heads for prayer. Dear long-awaited Jesus, we know that even though we may feel like your delivery is delayed, we know that you'll come just on time. We thank you so much for the gift that you gave us, not just one gift, but the many gifts, the gift of your coming to this earth, your gift of a sacrifice on the cross, and the gift of eternity that awaits us. We thank you that you are our deliverer. We pray in your name. Amen.